Hello students, so in the previous class we were discussing about that of the formation of the soil and that of the mineral riches. Before that student we discussed about that of the soil. What is soil? So soil is the, you can say it is a upper shallow layer where all the living and that of the non-living, you can say it is a complex mixture, consisting of a complex mixture of the living and non-living components of it. If we talk about soil students, so soil is consisting of the minerals, and these minerals, water, as well as that of the inorganic component, which is very essential for the proper growth and development of the plants. So you can say for the survival of the plant or the survival of the living organism, this is a very main or very important natural resource. Later on we discussed today that how the formation of the soil occur. So if we talk about the formation of the soil, so it mainly occur due to the decomposition. It mainly consisting of the it is the degraded form of the inorganic and that of the organic matter. If we talk about the inorganic matter, inorganic matter is formed of the decomposition of the rocks. Now the decomposition of the rocks, student, basically it can occur by that of the physical process, by chemical process, by biological process. Okay, so all this chemical or physical or the biological process responsible for the decomposition of the rocks. Now not only this, student, but the decomposition of the rock is influenced by certain factors. What was that? Let me remind you again. That is sunlight, that is water, then wind is there, and finally living organism. So you see, all these are the important factors which play a very important role in the decomposition of the rock. We discussed about that of the sunlight, student. What happened in the sunlight? Due to continuous fall of the sunlight on the rock, makes the rock heat. Okay, and due to this heat, the rock get expand. Okay, so expansion of the rock. Now this happens during the day. What happens during the night, students? So during the night, the temperature is very low, and due to the low temperature, it again get contracted. Now expansion during the day due to the continuous fall of the sunlight on a day, and contraction due to the low temperature. So expansion and contraction is continuously going on when if you talk about that of the sunlight. So due to this continuous expansion and that of the contraction, it makes a crack on that of the rock. Okay, and due to the formation of the crack, finally it will make the rock weaker and it will get converted into the smaller pieces. So we can say that sunlight, it is due to the contraction and expansion. So due to contraction and expansion, there is a formation of a crack in that of the rock. If we talk about the water, student, we discussed that water help in two ways. The first one, that it help in widening that of the gaps which is present in the rocks. So it goes inside to that of the rock, student, and if a gap is there, this flow of water will help in increasing the gap. So the first one is increasing or widening of the gaps. Widening of gaps in the rock. This is the first one. Second one is that with its flow it used to carry some of the rock with itself, and while moving with the water, this rock will get collide with the other rock materials also, and due to this abrasion, this big rock particles will get converted into the smaller pieces. So we can say that the second way is the abrasion of the rocks. And how does it occur? When it starts moving with that of the water, it will collide with the other rock material, and thus there they get breaks into the smaller pieces. So by this method, by these two ways, the water it helps in the decomposition of the rock. Now, if we talk about the wind, students, so in case of a wind, you see, student, like that of the water, the wind also used to carry the small rock particles, small sand particles with it due to that of the wind current. And this sand particles, when it rub against the other rocks, then it will help in the wearing of the rocks. So likewise, that of the water, when it means the water used to carry the rock particles with its flow, and when it rub with the other particles, it will start getting converted into the smaller pieces. Okay, or the wearing of the rocks can easily be possible. Likewise, if you talk about that of the wind also, here wind also used to carry the sand particle with it. Okay, so we can write a similar to water, wind current carries sand particles with it. Now these particles rub against other and help in wearing of rocks. So you see here, students, wind, it used to carry the sand particle with its current, and then what happened? And then these particles, they rub against each other, they rub against the other particle, and finally which will help in the wearing of the rock. So it is very similar to that of the water. Water also, it used to carry the sand particle with the water current, and wind also used to carry the particle with the wind current. Now if we move to the next one, student, the next factor which influences the formation of that of the soil is the living organism. How living organism? You see, if we talk about the living organism, so you see the living organisms, if we talk about the living organism, students, so there are certain microorganisms, there are certain fungi is there, lichen is there, algae is there, mosses are there. So these are what they used to stay, they used to cover up the rock. And if they are present on the rock, not only this, they used to release a chemical, chemical secretion is going on, a biochemical secretion is going on by these living organisms. And due to this biochemical secretion by the living organism, makes the rock weak. And finally, it will degrade it into smaller pieces. Okay, or help in the formation of the soil. So we can write it that living organism, especially that of the living organism, especially microorganism, organisms, lichen, fungi, mosses, algae, which grow on the crops, help in the decomposition. By releasing the by releasing certain biochemical secretion which makes the rock weaker. So you see here student, these living organisms, they used to you can say that they especially that of the lichen, fungi, algae, they used to grow on the rocks, not on the crops but on the rocks, which helps the decomposition. How it help in the decomposition of the rock students? By releasing, they used to grow on the rock, and there they used to continuously they used to release some biochemical secretion is secreted by these all living organism, and due to this secretion will makes the rock weaker, and finally due to this the decomposition of the rocks occur. Okay, so organisms which sit on the rock, which grow on the rock, also responsible for the decomposition of the rocks. Now let me remind you again that decomposition of the rock is important for the formation of the soil and mineral riches, students. It is that of the inorganic component which help in the inorganic component of the soil, and which is formed, this inorganic component is formed due to the decomposition of the rock. How the decomposition of the rock occurs, students? So lot of factors are there, including the sunlight. So due to continuous contraction and expansion of the sunlight, means sunlight when falls, then the rocks expand, and during night it contract. So due to contraction and expansion, it will a crack is formed in that of the rock. So the first one is the sunlight. If we talk about the second one, students, so water help in two ways. I discuss is that it help in going inside to that of the rock and widening the gap which is present in the rock, as well as it used to carry the materials with it, and it used to carry the sand particles with its flow, and these sand particles while coming used to rub with the other particles, and due to which it helps in the wearing of the rock. Same thing happened with that of the wind also. So wind current, it used to carry these sand particles, and again due to the rub against that of the other particles, it will help in the wearing of rocks. Finally, the living organism. So living organism like lichen, fungi, moss is there, algae is there, microorganisms. So all they used to grow on the rocks, and they release the biochemical secretion, and due to this biochemical secretion by this all living organism growing on the rock, it will help in decomposition by making the rock weak. Okay, so this is how the decomposition of the rock occur, and how it will help in the formation of the soil. Now we will discuss the next one, student, and that is the soil fertility. How the soil is important for the crop? We said that plants, they used to grow on the soil. So why is it so? It is because of the nutrients which is present in the soil help the growth of the crops. So soil consisting of humus, soil consisting of the water, as well as it consisting of a nutrient in it which is responsible for the proper growth of the plant. Now the presence of the nutrient decides that whether the soil is fertile or not. So let us discuss the soil fertility and its depletion also, because these days you see students, the quality of the soil is also degraded. Okay, so that is comes in a depletion of the soil. Soil and depletion. Soil fertility and its depletion. Okay? Soil fertility and its depletion. If we talk about the soil fertility, students, so what is the fertile soil or what is the fertility of the soil? So you can say that the capacity of that of the soil to sustain the plant life with the proper or with the required nutrients, that is known as the fertility of the soil. Means soil must have the proper nutrient, required nutrient, and due to which the plant, they are able to sustain there, they are able to survive there, it will just the fertility of the soil. So we can write it fertility of the soil or soil fertility. The capacity of the soil, the capacity of the soil which makes the plants to sustain with required nutrients with required nutrients, that is known as the fertility of the soil. So soil fertility is the capacity of the soil which makes the plants to sustain with required nutrients, that is the soil fertility. Now you see here, student, if we talk about the fertility, what does that mean? It means the soil must consist of a proper nutrient. Proper nutrient which will increase its quality. Okay, you know that we used to the crops, they used to grow in the soil because soil is having the nutrient. So these nutrient will be taken up by that of the plant, and thus it will make them to fulfill the required element, required nutrient to that of the plant, and thus help in the growth and the development of the plant. And since the soil which is helpful for the growth and the development of the soil, such kind of a soil is known as the fertile soil. Okay, so we can say that fertile soil provides the nutrients to the plants. Okay, fertile soil, it provides the nutrient to the plants, and thus helps in the growth and development of the plant. So we can write it, help in the growth and development of the soil. So by this student, we can say that for the proper growth and development of the plant, the soil must be fertile, must be consisting of a proper required nutrient for the plants. Otherwise, what will happen? The plant will not grow properly in that particular soil. Okay, so fertility of the soil is very important for the growth of the crops. Now we discussed about the soil fertility, student. In which we discussed that the soil must be fertile, must consisting of the proper nutrients, must consisting of the proper amount of the humus as well as minerals, you can say. So all these things must be present in that of the soil, which increases its fertility, and it is very important for the growth of the crop. Now the second one is depletion. Is depletion? It means that when the soil will be not fertile or the depletion of the fertility of the soil, what will happen? What is the impact of the depletion of the soil, as well as what is the causes of the depletion of the soil fertility? Means soil is fertile, but due to some activity, this fertility of the soil will become less. How and why is it so? Okay, so we'll discuss about the depletion. So we'll discuss the causes of the depletion of the fertility of the soil. So what are the different causes? So if we see the first one is student, and that is soil erosion. So soil erosion is the first cause, you can say, for the depletion of the soil fertility. Reason is, student, what is soil erosion? First of all, soil erosion is the removal of the top layer of the soil from one place to that of the other place. Okay, now what will happen if suppose we are saying that the removal of the top layer of the soil from one place to another, is it going to affect it? Yes. Removal of the top layer of the soil consisting of a lot of a nutrient which we call as a humus also, and which increases the fertility of the soil. Now the portion of the soil which is already fertile, okay, or which is responsible for the fertility of the soil, if that portion, if that layer change its position or move from one position to the other place, or one place to that of the other place, obviously the fertile layer will move on, then nothing will be there and automatically the fertility of the soil will get decreases. So first of all, we will write that what is soil erosion. So soil erosion is the removal of the top layer of the soil from one place to another place is soil erosion. Okay, so removal of the top layer of the soil from one place to that of the other place is called as a soil erosion or a soil erosion. Now what will happen, student? Why the removal of the top layer will going to affect the fertility of the soil? So we can write it, the removal of the affects the fertility of the soil, since it consisting of minerals, or we can say it consisting of a humus in it. Okay, so removal of the humus from humus from that of the from that of the soil will degrade the quality, will decrease the fertility of the soil. So we can write it. Since the top layer is very rich in nutrient or having the humus, so removal of the top layer will decreases the quality. Since the top layer having humus rich in nutrient, top layer is having humus, thus it decreases the fertility of the soil. Okay, so it will adversely affect the fertility of the soil if the top layer is get removed due to that of the heavy rainfall student or by that of the wind. So you see that if the top layer get removed, it will cause the soil erosion. Okay, so fertile layer will move from one place to another, that is known as a soil erosion. Now if we see the second one, students, so second one is the removal of the vegetation cover. Okay, so second one is the removal of the vegetation cover, students. So you see, when the natural vegetation is removed, now this vegetation, it also consisting of a very essential nutrient in it which used to go to the soil. Okay, so when the natural vegetation is removed, so the amount of nutrients which reaches to the soil will also get lost. Not only this, the nutrients which is present in the soil will also be gradually it get reduced, become less, or ultimately it will be finished. So what I want to say that if the vegetation is continuously removed, then the nutrients will not going to pass in that of the soil, and finally removal of the vegetation cover will going to make the soil deplete in that of the nutrient, or make it in less in that of the nutrients in it. So we can write it, when natural vegetation is removed, when natural is removed, the nutrients which is present in that of the vegetation or the organic matter which is present in the soil will also get reduced. So we can write it, the nutrients which is present in the vegetation as well as the organic matter which is present in the soil will also get reduced. Okay, so when the natural vegetation is removed, the nutrient which is present in the vegetation as well as the organic matter which is present in the soil will also get reduced, and thus you can say the fertility of the soil will get reduced. So we can write it that is, this significantly reduces the fertility of the soil. So if the natural vegetation is removed, student, the nutrient which is present in the natural vegetation which goes to the soil and increases the fertility. Not only this, the continuous removal will make the organic matter which is present in that of the soil also, that will also get lost with a period of a time. So we can say that removal of the natural vegetation will going to reduce the nutrient in the soil, and thus it will gives a bad effect, or it will makes the soil infertile, okay, or help the soil in reducing that of the fertility of the soil. Okay, so this is the second one in which we can say that removal of the natural vegetation will also affect the fertility of that of the soil. Okay.